that I need to just relax and get away from so much stress. And since the doctor said that there's nothing wrong with you, then what? I am not keeping anything from you. I told you everything. Hey, how about we pray about it, okay? Okay. It's gonna happen.
All right.
What? Yes, Jonathan sounds like a lovely name for a boy. I'll add it to the list. I gotta go. Okay. I love you too. Bye. It's gonna happen. It's gonna happen. Oh, please, God, let it happen. Okay. Please, God, please listen to me. Please hear my prayer. I need this to happen for me.
Majora. Majora.
Yes, God?
Majora.
Oh, Doctor! Hi! Good morning.
Good morning. How are we feeling today?
Oh, we're fine. Just fine. So the test results in?
They did. Why don't you have a seat?
Okay.
Is that amethyst passion you're wearing?
Yes, it is.
Why, that's my favorite fragrance.
No way, mine too!
You know, about many women can't wear it. Something to do with having the right kind of body chemistry.
I heard that too. Yeah. I'm sorry. The test results?
I'm sorry. Why don't you help me?
Okay,
saying your chances don't look as promising as I had hoped. When you didn't seek medical care during your first pregnancy, and there was no follow-up treatment after you miscarried, you severely reduced your chances of conceiving. Now, your condition is rare.
Okay, wait, it's just one second. You gotta help me. I can't let that mistake. Doctor, I was so young. I was only 15. He told me he loved me, and I believed him. I couldn't tell my parents. He's a pastor, you know, my father. The Reverend Dr. Joshua Garrison. And oh God, my mother. She would have died of the shame. The pastor's only daughter. His little angel. Pregnant. God, I was so terrified that I just pretend like it wasn't there. This thing growing inside of me. You know, I thought if I prayed hard enough and asked God to forgive me, that he would wake me from this nightmare and everything would be okay. So that's what I did. I prayed and I prayed and I prayed, but it was still there and it wasn't going anywhere. I watched as my belly grew round and hard. Started wearing baggy clothes so no one would notice. You know, sometimes I would catch my mother looking at me strangely, but she never said anything. Besides, she was always so busy, you know, teaching Sunday school and visiting the sick and the shut-in and taking care of Daddy. Out of my bed to the bathroom. when it was over. I cleaned up the bloody sheets and towels. Turned off that damn faucet. And I just went back to bed. I was sick for the next 2 days. There was something wrong. My parents, they let me stay home from school. They believe my really bad cramp story. Besides, they were such busy people. It's funny how people only see what they want to see. Isn't it? Well, when I couldn't take the pain much longer, my girlfriend, Debbie, she took me to this free clinic that would treat me without contacting my parents. And they did. They took care of the pain, but they wanted me to come back for follow-up treatment. And God, I didn't go, of course, because it was gone, and that was all that mattered, right? But now you're telling me that I can't have babies. And I can't tell my husband.
Why?
Because I don't want him to leave me. Children are everything to him, to us. I'm an only child, and so is Scott. So we decided that we would just build our own legacy. We promised ourselves that we would start our family after our first year together. It's been 3. Nothing. I want 4, you know. 3 boys. And a little girl. But he thinks that he's married the perfect little angel, the pastor's daughter. Everyone thinks that we're this golden couple. But he is starting to get impatient. He's asking questions, he's looking for answers, and our marriage is feeling strained, but we still, you know, laugh. And we have our good times together. Sometimes, when we're out and we see other couples with their children, with their babies, how happy they are. Doctor, you've got to help me, please. I'm desperate. I can't keep lying to him. But how do I tell him what I did? How do I tell him that I can't have his baby?
I didn't say you can't have babies. I said your chances of conceiving have been reduced. Mature.
Yes.
Your husband needs to know what's going on.
Oh, no, no.
No, it's not fair.
Not fair? No, it's not fair.
He knows you don't understand.
God.
Why don't you bring him in and we all sit down and discuss your options? You might even want to consider adoption.
Adoption?
Yes, there are a lot of children out there who need a loving family.
Are you crazy? I can't do that. And exactly what am I supposed to say to him, huh? Hey, Scott, you know that perfect little wife that you married? Well, she opted to become a slut at the age of 15, got pregnant, had a miscarriage, and now she can't have any babies. Hey, how about we just adopt one? That is out of the question. What about our legacy? Raise another woman's child?
Yes. Raise another woman's child.
No. It's not gonna happen.
You know, maybe there was a young girl who was just as naive as you were. Let some teenage jock lead her into something she wasn't ready for. And just maybe that young girl didn't lose her baby, but carried it to term. A beautiful, strong, healthy baby girl. She always dreamed of having a little girl. And just maybe that young girl knew, no matter how much she loved her, how much she desperately wanted to keep her, she knew she couldn't give her the life she deserved. So as much as it hurt, as much as it pained her, she let her little angel go. Let her be put up for adoption. And just maybe there was a young deserving couple who couldn't have children of their own, but desperately wanted a child.
That was you, wasn't it? You gave up your baby for adoption? How could you do that? How could you be so?
Strong, healthy,
baby girl.